When you go inside, there is the order of service that you'll be given by the verger, okay? Alongside that, there's a little packet of poppy seeds that you can all have one each, okay? Now, we must be sitting in our family bubbles, okay? There are numbered pews, so if we can sit on the pews that have got the numbers, and that just allows that people are maintaining their safe social distances, okay? So just sit within your households, please, okay?
Steve.
week.
Yeah.
Yes,
good.
Good.
Oh, am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. I'm convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Welcome to St. James's Church this morning as we give God thanks for Lyn's life and commit her into the safe keeping of God. You will see that on the communion table we have a candle, a poppy candle lit. As you know, Lyn was very fond of poppies, and I hope you managed to pick up one of the envelopes of poppy seeds on your way in. If not, please take one on your way out and plant them in her memory. Let's begin with a prayer. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, who loves us with an everlasting love and can turn the shadow of death into the morning, help us now to wait upon you with reverent and submissive hearts. In the silence of this hour, speak to us of eternal things, that through patience and comfort of the Scriptures, we may have hope and be lifted above our darkness and distress into the light and peace of your presence, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Fortunately, as you know, we can't sing in church or anywhere at the moment, but we are going to listen to the hymn, Abide With Me. reading from Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So we're here today, I think, to do three things primarily. First is to give God thanks for Lyn's life. Second, as I've said, is to commit her to the safekeeping of Almighty God. And the third thing is to pray and support those who mourn and miss her the most. But first, some words about Lyn, and most of these words come from her own notes, her own recollections that she wanted read out at this service. She was born in Milford Haven in Wales and had a lovely, enjoyable childhood. She moved to Shirley when she was 12, attended Tudor Grange Grammar School as it was in the school choir, took part in athletics and was the school champion. She trained to be a teacher and worked for all of her career, some 40 years, at one school, Yarnfield School in Yardley. In Tisley. She loved her job and made lifelong friends there. She met her beloved Stan through her sister Dillis. Stan was sharing a house with Bob, who Dillis married. And Lyn married Stan in 1974. They had three children, Dave and Dan and Esther. Their home was in Limbrick Close. They had a great friendship with their neighbours, Maggie and Neil. Neil, who sadly died last year. And with their children. And Maggie has been in continued support, even in these last few weeks and months. It was a happy time. Happy and content, a loving home, family around them, holidays to Wales and France, very special times, enjoyable times, great memories. Sadly, just before, a year or so before Lyn retired from work, Stan passed away. She lost the love of her life and had to adapt to a different kind of life. But the following February, her first grandchild, Lily, was born, Dan's eldest daughter, and that gave her a new purpose. And then later that year, she retired from her long career as a teacher. She began to enjoy her retirement with her dogs, Mabel, Hattie, and later Gladys, gradually gained confidence to travel on her own, and went to see family in Wales and Scotland, visiting Portsmouth and Cardiff to see other members of her family. By 2016, the family had grown to include four grandchildren, Lily, Annabelle, George, and Bea. And Lyn treasured every moment with them. And the laughter and love that they provided gave a new outlook on life. And she developed new hobbies in her retirement, patchwork, crochet, new challenges, loving every moment and spending time with long-standing friends as well as making new ones. Gardening, her love of her dogs, faithful and loving companions going everywhere with her. Belonging to the Women's Institute, new interests, opportunity to make still more friends. And of course, lots of babysitting for the grandchildren, building up special bonds with them. You perhaps remember, have your own memories of Lyn, a well-respected, generous, organized, calm, kind, inspiring, caring, empathetic person. All those words have been shared with me. Sadly, this last year has been particularly hard with her cancer and hospital treatment, especially with all the restrictions brought about by the COVID virus. And maybe those thoughts that she's asked us to read out have reminded you of times you've spent together, of special moments in your life, of conversations you had, of things that you did, of words spoken and heard and listened to. Maybe you can remember the influence that she's been upon your life and the way that she has in some way helped to make you the person that you are today. So of course, a day like this is a sad day, but it's also a day when we're right to give God thanks for a life that was well lived, a life that meant so much to so many people, a life the memory of which will live on beyond. And so we do give thanks for all that she was, all that she achieved, all that she did, and the special person that she was. But we're here as well to commit her to God. Maybe in these strange times in which we live, maybe you wonder about some of the big questions of life: suffering, pain, sorrow, death. Times like this make us ask questions, and they're not very comfortable questions, perhaps ones we don't know the answers to. Maybe we're not even sure where to look for those answers. Where is God in all of this? We've come together in church today to remember Lyn and to pray to God. But where has he been in this last year? Why do so many bad things happen to those that we love and care about? Why is there suffering? And these are good questions and ones that we shouldn't hide away. The Christian faith doesn't discourage those kinds of questions, but it does offer some hope. We've just celebrated Easter, the resurrection of Jesus, where hope comes from despair. And that's a message to carry with us today. The Christian message is a message of hope, that through the life and death and resurrection of Jesus, he's opened a way to a life beyond this one, a life in the presence of God forevermore, free from pain, free from suffering, free from all the things that have held us back in this life, free for us to be the person that we were created to be. And we trust that Lyn is there now in the greater presence of God, that the love that she showed amongst us lives on in God's presence into eternity. And so we entrust her to God's safekeeping. But we're here as well to look to the future. Because life here goes on, it won't be the same, it can't be the same. We've heard how Lyn herself had to adjust to life without her husband. And you'll have to adjust to life without her too. She will be missed, of course she will, especially by Dave and Dan and Esther and grandchildren and many, many more. But can I encourage you to relive those memories, to talk about her, to remember the conversations you had and the things that you did, perhaps look at old photographs, share the jokes, whatever it may be. One of the saddest things I ever hear when speaking to people who've been bereaved, I've heard people walk down the street and they say they see someone coming towards them, a friend, and they see that person cross over the road because that person is fearful and doesn't know what to say. If that person is you, don't cross over the road. Talk about your own memories of Lyn. Relive those things. Share those thoughts. That's what Dave and Dan and Esther would love to hear, I'm sure. To recollect the things of how important, how special she was. But there may be times when human comfort is not enough. Perhaps then we can turn to God. One of the sentences of scripture I read at the start of the service comes from the Old Testament. It goes like this: "The eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms." That's a lovely picture of God, a refuge, a home, a safe place to be who we are and to say how we feel. and a God whose arms are outstretched beneath us, ready to embrace us, or if we fall, to catch us. It's not a bad picture of God to take with us in these sad and difficult times. So today, let's give God thanks for Lyn's life. Let's commit her to his safekeeping, and let's commit ourselves to pray and support those who mourn. I'm going to leave a few moments silence now as we just think of our own thoughts, our own memories, bring our own prayers to God, and then we'll listen to some music. Lord of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Lyn, for the grace and mercy she received from you, for all that was good in her life, and for the many memories that we treasure today. Perhaps in a moment of quiet, you'd like to thank God for particular memories that you have of yourself. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You promised eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good this your servant as we remember her, and bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy on Dave and Dan and Esther and all who mourn. Give them patient faith in times of darkness and strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You are tender towards your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal the memories of hurt and failure. Give us the wisdom and the grace to use aright the time that's left to us here on earth, to turn to Christ and follow in his steps in the way that leads to everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of mercy, entrusting into your hands all that you've made and rejoicing in our communion with all your faithful people, we make our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. I invite you to join with me in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. To read the poem, Feel No Guilt in Laughter. Feel no guilt in laughter, should know how much you care. Feel no sorrow in a smile that she's not here to share. You cannot grieve forever, she would not want you to. She'd hope that you could live your life the way you always do. So, talk about the good times and the way you showed you cared, the days you spent together, all the happiness you shared. Let memories surround you. A word someone may say will suddenly recapture a time, an hour, or a day that brings her back as clearly as though she were still here and fills you with the feeling that she's always near. For if you keep those moments, you will never be apart, and she will live forever, locked safely within your heart. So let us commend Lyn to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Father, by your mighty power you gave us life, and in your love you've given us new life in Christ Jesus. We entrust Lyn to your merciful keeping, in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again to save us, and is now alive and remains with you and the Holy Spirit in glory forever. Amen. And we listen to the hymn, Guide Me, O Thou Great Redeemer. Father of all, by whose mercy and grace your saints remain in everlasting light and peace, we remember with thanksgiving those whom we love but see no longer. And we pray that in them your perfect will may be fulfilled. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So may God give you his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy, in this world and the next. Blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Thank you.
Let me get to church. I'm just going to ask that to
you. I need Mr. Rogers.
Thank you.